live outside CPS headquarters now with more on that part of the story, Mike.
Ben and Julie, good afternoon to both of you. If it felt like the first few days of the strike were all about posturing, now we're into the pressuring aspect of the strike, and there is pressure on both sides as people not directly involved in these negotiations are starting to lose opportunities and income.
During the strike, we've been trying to entertain ourselves by going to the various parks.
Shireen Punja is at a Northside park with her six-year-old daughter, Safina, a CPS first grader, while the Chicago teachers are on strike. She stayed home from work this week, but says it can't go on much longer.
I'm a physician, so I would be at work, but I've been fortunate enough to take some time off to be with her this week, not knowing how long this is going to last.
That's what grandparents are for.
Anne Marie Finger is a retired teacher watching her grandkids during the strike, and she says she knows the pressure is mounting.
One would hope that both sides would use that feeling of crisis to really work especially hard to reach an agreement.
Chicago Public Schools could stop contributing to teachers' health insurance premiums as early as next week.
If you need medical stuff, you got to pay up the COBRA, which is really expensive, so that puts pressure.
Chuck Lair is a second grade teacher at Coonley Elementary.
We're going to miss a whole check now.
He says while some teachers are dipping into savings, many live paycheck to paycheck and will feel the impact soon because there's no special strike fund set up by the union.
We don't get paid anything by the union.
These kids who have really become the collateral damage of this strike.
Another consequence of the strike is the impact on athletics. At the Daily Center today, lawyers filed a lawsuit on behalf of thousands of CPS student athletes asking that they be allowed to compete during the state tournament.
We are going to be seeking a motion for temporary restraining order to prohibit IHSA and CPS from preventing our student athletes from competing this weekend and throughout the state series.
Some students are worried about losing the chance at a scholarship.
This was his chance to get a scholarship, and he's not being allowed to do that just because we can't play on the field.
The solution is to ensure that our students are back on the field and back on the court, is to have them back in the classroom.
And in order to get those students back in the classroom, of course, the strike would have to end, and we appear no closer to that tonight, as officials have just announced that school will be canceled yet again tomorrow.